This festive season, enjoy cooking meals while conserving the environment using Ebenezer Energy Saving Stove,
which uses volcanic stones for heating and cooking your meal as fast as you can. The stove also comes with an addition of a solar and lights.
These can be for home or commercial use, and they are at a discount. For these stoves are proudly made in Uganda. For more information on how to access us, please contact us on the addresses on your screen and do not miss out on this opportunity.
The high cost of capital available to banks in Uganda still makes it hard for financial institutions to bring down interest rates. To experts, there is a continuing mismatch between the nature of money available for lending and the needs of the market.
Depositors, and I'm sure Will Broad will attest to this fact, save their money for extremely short durations. There's a high degree of volatility as to when depositors will withdraw their money. Therefore, in contrast, borrowers are looking for longer term financing. Therefore, you have short term deposits, but borrowers were looking for long term financing, and there's a mismatch between them.
Such a mismatch, according to experts, is not only a contributor to the high interest rates, but also a contributor to the many buffers to lending to certain sections of the market, such as agriculture and manufacturing.
The banks, their tendency from the statistics is to lend to sectors that for me I wouldn't really call productive. We can have a debate on that. There's a lot of dead capital when you put up a lot of buildings, and the cases we've had coming up of recent have not been that the banks were financing this manufacturing plant and is a problem. It's a building, it's what? So the focus.
This situation, according to the FinScope 2018 study, is compounded by the inherent low deposit rates in the country.
Only 3% of the poorest adults in the country do business with banks. Of the middle income, only 13% of adults do business with banks. And of the richest, only 23% do business with banks.
To pundits, financial institutions, especially banks, have not put money where it matters most, hence starving the progressive portion of the economy of the much-needed capital, a situation that also comes back to haunt the banking industry, ridding it of the needed growth of both deposits and revenue.